It's no secret that I love creating more than cleaning up afterwards. That's why I sometimes tend to ruin my paintbrushes, palette knives, brayers, you name it. It's not that I don't want to clean them. It's that while I'm creating, I'm so in the zone that I sometimes forget to wash my tools right away. I do put my brushes in water, but when I'm actually done, I'm embarrassed to say this, I get up and leave the brushes in water, sometimes for days. I can't tell you how gross that water is. That's why a few years ago, I found a product that could clean my tools even if they're caked on with mixed media layers, and therefore allows me to be me, faults and all, because with this product, I can have the cake and eat it too. And yes, I know as soon as I reveal the product, you're probably gonna click this video off, but consider staying for one more minute as I will share with you all the necessary tips to make sure it works for you. The product is called Murphy's Oil, and it is sold as a floor cleaner. Usually I avoid cleaning products because I hate doing chores, but in this case, it was the perfect solution. I took a bucket and filled it with water. Then I added Murphy's oil and mixed it. Then I added all my tools and let them soak for 24 hours. Now it was time to take care of the gunk. You may use gloves for this part if you want, as it's a bit gross, and the chemicals of the soap might be harsh for your hands. I started peeling some of the caked on acrylic paint and paste layers from my tools. Now this is where it got tricky, because there were so many layers caked on the brayer that I was only able to remove one of them. This is the first brayer I've ever bought, and I need to confess that I have never cleaned it, not even once. So it has way too many layers. Even the other brayers did too. So after removing the first layer from all the brayers, I put them back in the bucket to let it soak again for another 24 hours. In the meantime, I tried removing the glue from some of the palette knives, but I found that those tools had caked on glue or gel, which is what I usually use these tools for. So they had to soak for longer. I had to leave some of the brushes to soak with the brayers. Depending on what material is on the brush affects how long it will take to remove it. But wait till the end of the video as I will show you what happened to the brushes. After another 24 hours, I came back and I was able to remove all the gunk from the palette knives, both in the metal part and on the handle. They looked almost brand new. The brayers were still harder to clean, but I was able to remove a few more layers from them. I actually got to see the original color of the rollers. I also added a couple of brayers that I had just used with acrylic paint to the bucket and let them soak for a few hours. And the paint literally slid off the surface, which made me think that I need to have a bucket with Murphy's oil sitting on my desk and soak my tool right after I use them. It would solve so many of these problems. And although I soaked the brushes thoroughly, not all of them went back to their original softness. But the good thing is that no brush has ever gone to waste, as I incorporated them into my art. Do you want to know how? Click this short playlist right here to see a few ideas.